If we've learned anything in the contemporary auto space, it's that there can never be enough SUVs, which is why Volkswagen has introduced a two-row version of its three-row Atlas. They're calling it the Atlas Crossport, and it looks to be a bit more stylized than its boxier brother, but let's dive in deeper right now. Before going into the exterior, two things to address up front. One, this Atlas Crossport is painted in the pure gray paint job. It's a bit of an add-on. And also, the Atlas Crossport compared to the regular Atlas is 5 inches shorter overall. Same wheelbase length, just shorter. Moving on to the design, we've got Volkswagen's corporate grille stretching from standard LED headlight to standard LED headlight. Looks very wide, but somehow fits the wide proportions of this Crossport. Down below, we have some notches in the lower air dam to match the notches in the grille itself. And interestingly, these pass-throughs for the vents are actual air pass-throughs, not fake vents like so many other cars these days. Over here on the side, we see standard 20-inch wheels on this SEL model, and they've got like a motion to them. I like the design, with black plastic cladding for the wheel arches, black plastic cladding. We know what that says. Rugged. This is an SUV after all. Crossport badging on the side. And then moving back, let's pause to look at the profile, because this is where the Atlas Crossport really distinguishes itself from the regular Atlas. It has the sloping roofline that people love these days in the coupe design SUVs, and the Atlas Crossport's sloping roof is not so aggressively sloped, so to cut into too much of the rear seat passenger space or of the cargo capacity, but we'll get there in a second. It actually just adds some nice style, especially from that profile view. And I didn't mention this character line that starts from that front wheel arch and comes all the way back to these LED tail lights. We see some chrome treatment below, stretches all the way across the trunk, Atlas spelled out over there, down here, more chrome treatment for the what look to be exhaust finishers, but that's not really what that is. It's just a design feature, more black plastic cladding down there, and the exhaust is actually tucked down in there, so you don't see it. Under the hood of the Atlas Crossport, you have your choice of two engines. As entry level, you have a 2-liter four-cylinder turbo that makes 235 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque. That's the one we have here, and it looks comically small in this big engine bay, but that's because they need to make enough space to fit the other engine option, which is a 3.5 liter V6, making 276 horsepower. So not all that much more than this little 2-liter four-cylinder turbo. And if you choose this engine and you choose front wheel drive, you will have 21 city, 24 highway, and 22 combined MPG. If you option on all wheel drive for $1,900 more, you lose 2 combined MPG, so 20 combined total. 0 to 60 for this 2-liter turbo is 7.2 seconds. Top speed, if you care, is 130 miles per hour. Inside the Atlas Crossport, the name of the game is space. I have plenty of space in this front cockpit, in the rear seats, and then of course cargo capacity. We'll get more into those in a second. Let's first talk design. So it's very industrial looking in here. We've got a dark metal finish for here, along with some silvery borders, piano black bordering around this touchscreen infotainment, that more of that silvery finish that goes across the dashboard, big chunky air vents, some stitching up here that's more premium side of things. So it's appealing in a more rugged looking way. Material quality is okay. There are some cheaper plastics below the belt line here. Some of this scratchy stuff. This does have leatherette material on the SEL trim. So leatherette surface for the center console, for these seats, for the armrests, and this contrast stitching here in the door panel. Then you get over here to the switchgear and the plastics get even cheaper. I don't like that. I don't like the sound. I don't like the feel. The SEL model that we have has dual zone climate control as standard, and I love this. Volkswagen brands their climate control system. It's called Climatronic. Registered trademark. Sounds like a robot. We also have wireless smartphone charging below. That is part of the SEL package as well. We've got a couple USB ports up there and an aux plug-in, a 12 volt as well. One USB port in there, and then two more back here, so five. You've got plenty for all of your smart devices. We've got a panoramic sunroof that's also part of the SEL package, and sort of fabric surfacing for the headliner. These visors, these feel super cheap. Super duper cheap. But on the bright side, they do slide. So you've got coverage from the sun. Digital instrument cluster is part of the SEL package, and it looks a little small especially in the dimensions of this interior cabin, it looks a little small, but it's fairly high resolution and user-friendly, easy to see what you're looking at day or night. And you've got some controls on the steering wheel. These front seats are heated with the SEL, as is the steering wheel. Standard on the Atlas Cross is a 6.5 inch touchscreen display, but on the SEL you get upgraded to this 8-inch model, which is pretty darn quick to respond, very user friendly. The graphics are not cutting edge, but it all works just fine. And it has both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, essential. You're also covered in terms of active safety features. In this SEL model, you have adaptive cruise control with lane keeping assist, in addition to the standard cars, blind spot monitoring with rear cross traffic alert, auto emergency braking, and frontal collision warning. Now let's move into the rear and see what we're working with. Now hopping into the rear, unlike a lot of these coupe SUVs, one, the door opening is massive. You should not have any problem getting in here. And then the slope of the roof is not so aggressive, so you don't have to dip your head too much. And once you're back here and the door is closed, you can spread out pretty nicely. So I have some big foot pockets so I can really stretch out my legs. 6 feet tall, sitting behind my own driving position, plenty of knee room. Headroom's okay in this position. I'm pretty darn close to that roof, but you can recline these seats all the way back here. So this is pretty much like a limousine now. I'm really stretched out. And assuming you don't have anything bulky back there to stop you from reclining, I would do this all the time. You can appreciate the panel sunroof from back here and mostly just the legroom. You also have a 115 volt plug back here, socket I should say, in addition to those two USB ports and air vents. So important, get your air vent on. Now let's see what we got in the trunk. Now around at the big old booty of the Atlas Crossport, you got a couple different ways you can open it, including hands-free. So you just swing your leg under, and it takes a second, but it will open up, revealing a massive cargo bay. So you've got 40 cubic feet of space behind that second row. If you fold those seats flat, they're 60-40 split folding, you have 77.8 cubic feet. That blows away all of the competitors for this Atlas Crossport. Guess that's the benefit of keeping the wheelbase the same length as the regular Atlas. All right, behind the wheel of the Atlas Crossport, and I'm already coming up to a stop here, but a good chance to test out the brakes. Let's start with the brakes. It is a big SUV, so you need confident stopping power, and you get that. That's no problem. How about acceleration? Pegging the throttle. And that 2 liter is a bit of a firecracker. It gets you going pretty quickly. Makes an interesting noise as well. So no problems with the acceleration. Mid-range acceleration. Okay, it takes a second. You gotta shift down. Wait for the gearbox to shift down with that 8-speed automatic, but it does what you want eventually and gets you into the right gear. This is not a sports car. Even if you go for the V6, it's not gonna be a sports car, but the power and transmission seem to do a good job here in most practical circumstances on a daily drive. Now, if you do want to go for all-wheel drive, you will have that extra confidence, especially if you were living in a climate with some winter weather. But we've just got the front-wheel drive model here, and that's all I think you will need for most of your use cases outside of a rougher climate. Now, let's get up to some highway speeds and see how it sounds inside the cabin. All right, now doing 65. And there's a bit of wind noise, but nothing too dramatic. Nothing that would be disturbing if you had to commute on the highway, that's for sure. So that gets a pass. Despite the boxier styling, it's not reflecting a lot of air and therefore adding to your cabin volume. And what about visibility? You gotta see out of your big SUV, so can we? Yes, pretty darn well actually. There's only a tiny little blind spot where the C-pillar meets, but if you do have blind spot monitoring, that takes care of that. So it checks that box for sure. So let's talk about the competition, because the Atlas Crossport has a few. It's got the Honda Passport as its probably closest rival. That one comes standard with a V6, and so it makes more power. It's got 280 horsepower. Starts around $32,000, so very similar to this one starting figure at $31,500. But the SEL we're testing here is right around $40,500. So you can load up some of the competitors to get similar in terms of your appointments on the interior. That Honda Passport also has similar cargo capacity to this. It's actually very, very close and stands with this as the most spacious in the segment. which also includes the Ford Edge, which makes a little more power than this in its 2-liter application and has less cargo capacity. Also gets 2 more combined MPG, so 24 for that one. And then there's the Chevy Blazer, which does start at $29,000, so less than this, but you get a weak sauce engine. You're not gonna choose that. You will opt for the 2-liter turbo. Then you're gonna get 230 horsepower, but it will start around $32,000. It's got less cargo capacity than this, but it does have 2 more combined MPG for a total of 24. So it's a decent spread. Everything is pretty similar in terms of available power and cargo capacity. Definitely the Pilot and the Crossport have more. Fuel economy, the Blazer and Ford Edge have more. So really it's gonna come down to styling preference. I find the Crossport to look pretty darn good, but interior appointments, I'm wanting more out of this Atlas Crossport, and I feel like perhaps the Honda Passport comes away with it in that regard. Because you get the same cargo capacity, because you get that standard V6 that, despite being a V6, gets similar fuel economy to this 2-liter 4-cylinder, that might be my favorite in the segment. But this is the runner-up for me. I don't really favor the Blazer and the Ford Edge compared to this Atlas Crossport. So, Honda Passport, then the Volkswagen Atlas Crossport. If you want to learn more about the 2020 Volkswagen Atlas Crossport or any of the competitors I mentioned, go ahead and click the link in the description below.